of your ministry spirit, unity of all night Greek, it's my pleasure to welcome to Utah service. Today we're going to be talking about the Palm Sunday journey of our elder brother Jesus. We hope that you'll find some new understanding and new insights into this powerful experience. Our music today is by our beloved Carrie Hillary, whom we're always delighted to have as part of our service. So sit back, relax, prop up your feet, and get ready for what I hope will be a wonderful journey for you. Thank you so much for being with us, and come back again. Okay.
Good morning. Ooh, that was good. Everybody's awake. I'd like to invite you to stand and join me in singing the first congregational song. When we listen, we will hear a still small voice so clear. From folk to reggae. You guys ready? Join in a circle of love.
Please welcome back Carrie Hillary. Thank you very much, Carrie. Good morning. My name is Ron, and I am a licensed Unity teacher here at Unity Walnut Creek, and it is my pleasure to welcome you to our service. Welcome, one and all. It's such a privilege to stand up here and see all your beautiful faces, all the likenesses of God. This is really cool. Please join me in welcoming our online community and turn around and waving. Good morning. We are so glad you are here. And please know that you are a special part of our spiritual community here at Unity of Walnut Creek. So thank you. And if you're here new at Unity here in the sanctuary, a special welcome to you. Welcome. We are glad that you chose to join us, and we hope that you the desire in your heart that brought you here is touched this morning. So thank you for being with us. Unity focuses on spiritual and universal truths. And one of these truths is that we know that there are as many paths to God, divine spirit, as there are hearts on this planet. And we respect every one of those. And so you may hear different teachings or different lyrics in our music as the service goes forward. That's because we know that they lead to one place, that divine spirit or God. Unity is also a positive path for spiritual living. And part of that spiritual path that makes it positive is gratitude. So we're going to do something a little different this morning in preparing for our intention. So before we say our affirmation that we say every Sunday, claiming there is only one power in the universe, I would like to invite you to close your eyes, take a deep breath, and then say thank you as you exhale, and then we'll say our affirmation, okay? So take a deep breath. And just say thank you. And now let's say our affirmation. There is only one presence and one power in the universe and in my life, the all-loving goodness of God. Now take a deep breath and just let that soak in. And let's say it again. There is only one presence and one power in the universe and in my life, the all-loving goodness of God. And take a deeper breath and let that soak in ever deeper. And once again, there is only one presence and one power in the universe and in my life, the all-loving goodness of God. So please stay seated and join us in our next musical selection.
Here we are. I invite you now to begin preparing for this time of prayer and reflection. And I invite our heart minister, Susan Monroe, to come forward and share with all of us our community prayer.
Today, this prayer is for our journey. Today, we pray for all of us who are on this life journey to know, to grow, to fulfill our purpose within this human experience. We trust in the guidance, support, and protection of the loving goodness of God. We find wisdom in the way that has been shown by our elder brother Jesus, whose faith, courage, and examples give us confidence to keep going. We remember that we are all one with God and each other, and that we never walk alone. We hold within our hearts compassion for ourselves and each other when we stumble upon our mistakes. We reach for the power of God to lift us up to continue along our way. Through the light, love, power, and guidance of the ever-present God within, we come to the place of our destiny in the right and perfect way, at the right and perfect time. For this, we are so grateful. We are so grateful. We are so grateful. And so it is. Thank you.
I invite you to continue this journey. As we go to meet and greet the Lord of our being, allow your chair to hold you, relax. And if you feel comfortable in doing so, you may close your eyes to shut out any visual distractions and allow this chant to connect us more deeply with this divine presence. Allow the affirmation of that truth of our being to settle upon us, accepting that identity of who we truly are. And breathing in and out through our hearts, allow the opening of the doorway to that inner sanctuary where we nestle in to its sweet places, snuggling deeper into all the areas that hold us near and dear to our beloved spirit and our spirit self. This is our sanctuary, our place of comfort, that we bring those things that are challenging us, that we bring our mistakes, our concerns, to be held closely in that love of God that lives there. This is our place of healing, where we bring our physical challenges, our mental challenges, our emotional challenges, to be healed by the transforming power of God. This is our place of peace, where we bring the chaos and noise outside ourselves, the conflicts of life, to to be nurtured peacefully, to surrender to that power of infinite peace. This is our place of prosperity, where we are able to release all lack, all limitations, anything that prevents us from enjoying the abundance that is ours by our divine birthright. Here in this place, this home of the heart, we are renewed, revitalized, restored, and re-energized. And we settle here now, taking in the gifts that are here to serve us, accepting them as our own, as we rest in the silence. How blessed the sweet release and relief that we have found in our sanctuary with God, in our time of renewal. And we bring this experience with us as we journey through our lives, each and every moment of each and every day. As we walk with our beloved Mother, Father, God, we express our gratitude for creating these moments, these tender moments, where we remember who we are, and filled with that divine love, we allow it to express out into our families, among our friends, within our communities, lifting them up to the truth of their being and guiding them to walk holding that truth as their light in the darkness. And we allow it to extend throughout our nation, healing the hurts, easing the pain, stilling the noise, bringing peace to the chaos and conflicts. And we send it forth over the mountains, across the oceans, connecting with and blessing every heart that beats within every living thing. For we know and trust this divine love to flow through us, to enfold and bless the world. Knowing that divine love flows through my heart, enfolding and blessing the world. Please join me. Divine love flows through my heart, enfolding and blessing the world. And again, divine love flows through my heart, enfolding and blessing the world. And once more with passion, divine love flows through my heart, enfolding and blessing the world. I am. And so it is. And together we affirm, amen.
If you know this, feel free to sing with me. Use me, oh God, I stand for you, and here I'll abide as you show me all that I must do. I used to think God was the Son, God is the Son, but God's so much more than the earth and the stars and all of creation. God is Creator, all and all, needing us to shine His light as me. Command my hands, what must they do? Command my life, it's here for you. God is the love that heals all creation. God is Creator, makes all things new. And God needs us to shine its light as me. Shine its light. One more. God needs us to shine its light as me, as you, so use me. Oh, God, I stand for you.
Everybody, Ms. Carrie Hillary. Thank you. Yeah. Morning, everybody.
Good morning.
My name is Javier Cortez, and it's truly my pleasure to highlight some of the upcoming events here at Unity Center of Walnut Creek. On April 1st, begin to deepen your understanding of radical forgiveness with Reverend Sheila in this two-day workshop. You will literally feel the power of radical forgiveness to heal your life, leaving you free, energized, and empowered. Let me repeat that one more time. Leaving free, energized, and empowered. So sign up. If you're interested in taking the step to join our Unity community as a member, or if you're interested in learning more about Unity, join Reverend David the first Sunday afternoon in April for our membership orientation class. This class is a prerequisite to becoming a member here. And I'd like to invite Mr. Mike up to the stage.
I've got something. I've got something for you to say yes to. Yes to the Unity classes that are starting on Tuesday. They're 8-week classes. On Tuesday, journey into the depth of your heart. Definitely to say yes to that. That's Reverend David and Jeannie, and that is a deeper journey into our heart that's ever been taught here. And this will be David's last class here before his retirement. Got to take that. Another one to say yes to is the Quantum Christ with Reverend Sheila, and that probably says itself. Everything about Christ that we really need to know. And Garrett Rhee is back at popular request, of course, for his esoteric teachings and spiritual psychology, and he'll be out by the welcome table if you have questions afterwards. And on Sunday, 1:30 on Sunday, the first Sunday after Easter, our spiritual principles of abundance, definitely to say yes to that. Reverend David and Jeannie again, they chose that time for the young parents, and they're going to have child care, and everyone is invited, but the particular time was set for the parents to come, and we're looking forward to seeing the parents and everybody else. Definitely to say yes to all these.
May I add something, Mike? May I add something? I know this isn't planned. Please forgive me. Because the Quantum Christ has workbooks, if you are planning to take it, I ask that there is a sign-up sheet on the welcome table. If you could just put your name and email, that way I know how many workbooks to prepare. But it is essential that I have some idea rather than making workbooks the night of the class. And the other thing I would like to offer is, I know some of you have been putting off taking the Radical Forgiveness Workshop. So I know that the early bird special will be ending soon. However, I have a special for you today. If you go into the bookstore, fill out a registration form, pay in full, instead of the $150 early bird, you can have it for $125, and that ends today at 1 o'clock. And that's all I have to say about that.
Find out about more of these events and other activities online and in today's bulletin. So now, until you hear the gong, please take a short moment to greet the people immediately around you.
Sit down. Might as well stay standing.
Me do, what would you have me
take a moment to look deep inside. Move away from your fear and your pride and ask, where would you have me go? And what would you have me do? What would you have me say?
So she didn't mention it this time, but she just wrote that last night hoping that it aligned with my message. She blew me away at the last service. That was all I could do to get up here, because it does, and it is something I say every morning. It's from Course in Miracles. Yeah, every morning at the end of prayer time, God, would you have me do? Where would you have me go? What would you have me say? And to whom? I'm willing to do your will. Just let me know in a way that I will understand. And it so ties into the message today. I want to kind of clarify before I get into the heart of it, because I know that for some of you, having come out of your former spiritual traditions, religious traditions, that many of you just tossed it into the trash and waited for the garbage men to pick it up on garbage day and take it away, never to look at it again. And then some of you held on to a little bit of it and begin to align it with these new concepts, these new teachings that you were receiving to kind of give you a newer understanding of what you were being taught before. And then some of you just totally went into the new teachings and grasped it and realized that undergirding it were some of the former traditions, but that as of now, it was all one, and it was nestled into that place of understanding and comprehension as you move through your life. And the reason I'm saying this is because I'm going to be talking to you about Palm Sunday. I'm going to talk to you about Jesus's journey, the journey of this man through his pathway to his destiny, to fulfilling his purpose. And he was a man. He was not a saint. He was a human being who grasped the understanding of his divinity, began to practice it to the degree that he embodied it, and then was able to step forward and show us how it was done and how it would lead us to our ultimate realization of all of the good that we wanted to see manifest in our lives. And the thing that makes it so important is that he was one of us and was able to do it. And so everything he said, everything he did, was to show us what we could do. And remember, he said an even greater. And this Palm Sunday journey is so amazing because here was someone who knew what was coming and said yes anyway. Stood up and said, what would you have me do? Where would you have me go? What would you have me say? And to whom? I am willing to do your will, even if it means that I will be tried and sentenced for a crime I did not commit and be nailed to a cross among thieves, because I know that I go to fulfill my purpose for being on this planet in this human embodiment, and that others who come after me will be better able to manage their difficulties, will be better able to endure the great challenges in their life. So I say yes, I am willing to do your will. So I want to utilize the scripture from Matthew 21, 1 through 11. You have handouts. I won't read it. I will paraphrase it. That way it won't take so much time and we can get to the meat of the matter. So Jesus comes on his way to Jerusalem with his disciples, and he goes through Bethphage and says to his disciples, at the end of town, the edge of town, you will find tied up a donkey and her young colt. Untie them and bring them to me. And if anyone says anything, tell them the master has need of them. The master he was referring to was master teacher. Now, this is where I got a little confused with this scripture, because the other versions of it just say colt, but in this one it says a donkey and its young colt. Now I could not understand why Jesus needed two donkeys to ride on. I didn't get it, unless, you know, he figured one would get tired and then he'd get off and get on the other one. I wasn't sure. And it troubled me because, you know, in unity, we're taught to look at the deeper meanings, right? And I could not reconcile it. I asked people, I did research, I was reading books that had it in there, and it never really satisfied me. And so over the years, that one has perplexed me. And I'd say maybe the first year that I taught the Quantum Christ, it hit me. I think I got it. Now, this is a Sheila-ism, okay? You know what that means, right? I made this up. okay? It's not in anybody's book. You won't find it on TV or on the internet, okay? But this is what I believe for me, that the young colt has never been ridden. And it could be that it might have some difficulty bearing its load. And so its mother coming along with it can comfort and reassure it and help it bear its load the way our mother God does for us. That's what came up for me. And for the first time, it made sense. That young colt was too young to walk alone. So our mother God, when we are too young, makes its presence known and walks firmly with us, that we know that God is walking with us. And there are times when we are stronger and more mature in our realizations that we might not be aware of the presence of God, but it's there. But in those times, we are meant to move forward by the power and the authority that has been given us by our Mother, Father, God. And so as Jesus makes this journey, he calls for this demonstration of the donkey and her young colt. And the disciples do as he asks and brings them back to him. And they lay their cloaks on both of them. And Jesus rides the colt, headed toward Jerusalem. And the crowds are gathered along the road, and they're throwing their cloaks down on the ground, and they're throwing palm branches on the ground, and they're heralding him. And they say that this was done in fulfillment of the prophecy that your king will come humbly riding a donkey, will not come grandiose and pompous and knowing it all, but knowing that the power is within him. So he comes humbly. And the crowds shout, "Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna to the Son of David. Hosanna in the highest heavens." And he begins to make his way to the ultimate of his destination. What does this have to do with us? Because you know that's where I'm going. Each of us has a purpose. Each of us has a destiny to be fulfilled. We would not be on this human plane in this body if this were not true. Some of us may know it. Some of us may not. Some of us may just be coming into the realization, first of all, that we even have a purpose or destiny or the realization of what it is. But what this message means for us is, first of all, he knew what was coming for him. And he said yes anyway. Are we willing to say yes to what we don't even know? Trusting that God will walk beside us in this journey, helping us carry our burden. That is one of the significances of this message. The other is that the power to overcome those challenges lie within us, and they were given to us before the journey began, before the world was. So let's look at the metaphysics of it, because it's going to deepen it even more for us. Jesus represents that aspect of us that has either come into its highest level of realization, its highest evolution in consciousness, or has the potential to come into that highest level of consciousness. And this potential, this highest level of consciousness, is known as the Christ. It was a divine title that Jesus was able to take on once he had achieved that level of knowingness. It was not his last name. Christ was not his last name. Somebody said it was Johnson. So he was Jesus the Christ because he accepted his divinity, discovered what it all meant, and used it. He's on his way to Jerusalem. Jerusalem, the name Jerusalem, means habitation of peace. And the significance of Jerusalem on this journey is that he went toward it in peace. No terror, no fear, no doubt. He was at peace with the process of life. He knew that he would never be led to anything that he could not handle. That's the message for us. We will never be led through or to anything for which we are not prepared. The preparation has already been made. The donkey and the colt are there. The clothes have been laid on the ground for us. The palm branches have been put there. And the crowd, and this represents those thoughts that are usually off in a million different places, but these thoughts that recognize something amazing is about to happen for us. And so they are shouting, Hosanna. Save now. It means save now. It means we are saved from our limited beliefs and ideas and thoughts. Those things that keep us locked in fear and doubt and lack and limitation. We are saved from that by our willingness to take the journey, to say yes, to say, I will go, I shall go, to see what the end will be. Bethphage represents a place of truth. It is a place where truth comes into its evolution, comes into realization. It is where we realize the truth. That nothing can stop me from my journey to my good, to my power, to my peace, to my wholeness, to my goal, to my purpose. Nothing can stop me because the way has already been prepared. Hosanna to the Son of David simply is saying that we are descendants of kings and queens. We are royalty. By being sons and daughters of that which is the all of the universe, we are royalty. And we are to honor ourselves as royalty. We are not the scum of the earth. We are not lowly worms of the dust. I don't care what they told you in your old theology. You are royalty. You are royalty. You deserve to ride with dignity, to celebrate your power. And that is not arrogance or conceit, because of who you are. You are sons and daughters of God. How could you be anything but royalty? We need to act like it. Each and every moment of each and every day, we walk out like royalty. In the name of the Lord, name means nature. And Lord represents that highest spiritual truth, which is the law, spiritual law. So we come in the nature of that highest spiritual truth. In other words, we align with spiritual truth. We align with the universal laws. And when we align with the universal laws, the highest spiritual realizations, we can't help but be successful no matter what befalls us. Because those conditions that we meet along the way are not there to destroy us. They're there to give us an opportunity to exercise our God muscle in the laboratory of our lives, to put God to the test in the laboratory of our lives, to prove God. That's what the Bible said, prove me, so why not? What you got to lose? Put it to the test, the litmus test. See if it works. I can say it does. I've seen it work. Many of you can say it works. So what are these things that come up for us in our lives that cause us to give up, or to lose faith, or to doubt ourselves, or to step into fear, or lack, or limitation? How many of you have ever had a life-threatening illness? Raise your hand. That's what I'm talking about. Put God to the test in that life-threatening illness. How many of us have lost a job, been fired, been laid off? Put God to the test. How many of us have lost a loved one to death or some end of a relationship or a marriage? I love it. I love it. Put God to the test. How many of you have had major financial difficulties? Put God to the test. And see if God will not pour you out a blessing that there is not room enough to spare. That's what I read. It works. As Reverend Johnny Coleman used to say, it works if you work it. I'm just saying. So that's what this is about. That's what this Palm Sunday journey is about. If he knew what was coming and went anyway, at least we have an idea it might not be quite so bad. Could we not say, I will go, I shall go, to see what the end will be? So there is a trinity of fulfillment. When we fulfill our destiny, our purpose, I believe that fulfill means filled full. We are filled full when we say yes and we go forward. And so there's a trinity. I Sheilaism, there's a trinity of fulfillment. The first is forgiveness. And it's forgiving ourselves for that which keeps us from fulfilling our purpose, meeting our destiny. And forgiving others whose actions may have prevented us at time from fulfilling our destiny. The second is compassion. Having compassion for ourselves, for the times we've made mistakes, knowingly or unknowingly. Knowing that we are in this human body and therefore we are subject to many of the human frailties. So to have compassion for ourselves as we try to figure out this journey. I don't know about you, I didn't get a roadmap. I just stepped out here. So far it's been interesting. And to forgive, to hold compassion for others who are struggling to find their way along their journey. And maybe in their misperceptions or unknowingness been in the way of yours. Hold compassion. Because I believe when people know better, they do better. And that we're all doing the best we can with what we know. But I'm inviting you to know more. And the final is that peace. That peace that comes when we're walking along that pathway. And it may not be perfect, but what we realize is, wow, it's humming. It's feeling good. It's feeling right. We know we're on the way. We know it. We know it. We know it. We can feel it in every fiber of our beings. Our cells are vibrating. That's at peace. They talk about that passes all understanding. So I invite you to close your eyes, please. Bring to mind that which you have discovered is your purpose, if you can. And if you cannot, bring to mind the desire to allow your purpose to come forth. And now I invite you to forgive whatever has caused you not to be able to fulfill that purpose. If it is something that you have done or not done, say, I forgive me. Together, I forgive me. If it has been something someone else did or did not do that caused you to be unable to fulfill your purpose, say with me, I forgive them. Together, I forgive them. And next, breathe in through your heart. Open your heart up now. Get in touch with compassion. And where you may have stumbled, where you may not have shown up fully to fulfill your purpose, say with me, I hold compassion in my heart for myself. Together, I hold compassion in my heart for myself. And for those who are out creating things in your life that are difficult, keeping you from focusing on your purpose, say, I hold compassion in my heart for them. Together, I hold compassion in my heart for them. And now just allow peace to flow through your being. Allow peace to wash over you. Feel that peace begin to flow from the top of your head to the soles of your feet, moving down throughout your entire body. And now say with me, I feel peace. I feel peace. I am peace. I am peace. Just let that peace be there. Take a deep breath. Exhale. When you're ready, you may open your eyes. Through forgiveness and compassion, I find peace. That is the way to that peaceful state about your journey. When you hold that forgiveness within you, when you allow that compassion to embrace you, whatever time it takes, whatever challenges you face, whatever difficulties show up, whatever pitfalls end up in the middle of the road, you can handle it because you are holding forgiveness and compassion for yourself and others. Through forgiveness and compassion, I find peace. Say that with me. Through forgiveness and compassion, I find peace. Again, through forgiveness and compassion, I find peace. Once more, through forgiveness and compassion, I find peace. Have a wonderful journey.
Thank you, Reverend Sheila. Just what the doctor ordered. I invite everyone to take a connection card from the seat pocket in front of you. We invite each of you to take a moment to fill out this card. With the card, you can request prayer support for something or someone in your life. In addition, our heart ministers are available after the service for that wonderful experience of personal prayer support. They are the ones wearing the lavender stoles. Prayer requests can also be sent anytime through our website. As you heard Reverend Sheila say, our spiritual focus this week is through forgiveness and compassion, I find peace. The ushers will receive your card with the offering towards the end of the music. It is now time for our prosperity celebration. For credit card donations, there are envelopes on the clipboards in the back of each chair. Or for those of you at home, just click on the donate button on the Watch Live page. As Unity's co-founder, American mystic Charles Fillmore said, God is a source of a mighty stream of substance, and you are a tributary of that stream, a channel of expression. Blessing the substance increases its flow. I invite you to take your tithe or offering in your hand. Be aware that God is the source of all your good. Repeat our affirmation with me together. Divine love through me blesses and multiplies all that I am, all that I have, all that I give, and all that I receive. And I'm truly grateful.
That is too high. Guide me across that river that is too high.
me to the edge.
Oh, but should I fall, rolling down that mountain, I'll know through it all. The courage I give myself will call your love right to my side. And I can't see the gifts of your love in front of me. When my shoulders grow weary from that heavy load, I'll have your love like a hand to hold. So lead me to a rock that is too high. Guide me across that river that is too wide. Sit beside me on this plain tonight. Should I wander and can't find your love? Should I wander and can't find your love? Should I wander and can't find your love?
Oh, do we have kids? Yay!
We are marching in the light of God. We are marching in the light of God.
Our beautiful children and young adults, we are just delighted to have you with us, and we want to bless you. So let's get those hands warmed up, reach out toward our beautiful children, and let's say together, children, you are loved, special, and important. The light of God shines through you. And let us join together and say our affirmation, a prayer for protection, actually, and sing our peace song. Together? Oh, is everybody holding hands? Are we ready? We're ready. Okay, here we go. The light of God surrounds us. The love of God enfolds us. The power of God protects us. And the presence of God watches over us. Wherever we are, God is, and all is well. And our peace song. joy and the peace in the earth right now. So let it shine and have fun.